Hey guys, it's Kevin. Today I'm going to show you how to maintain your 1390 based DTF printer so your white will not clog and you can take vacations 10-15 days later. Your printer can go back to production within 10 minutes. I will not call this a daily maintenance because you don't have to do every day. You do not have to print a page every day. I'm going to show you the secret sauce of doing this. If you follow this video, your DTF printer is just like a microwave. Press a button, works. If you do not need to print, don't touch that printer, just leave it there. For example, if you print on Monday, shut it down properly, and the next time, maybe next Monday, or maybe next Thursday. My record is I went to Japan for 14 days and come back. 10 minutes later, it's back to production. I'm not going to tell you where to get this kit, but in the kit, find this water solution. This solution is concentrated, so we're going to dilute it with distilled water. You can get distilled water from a grocery store and find like a bottle close to 1 liter. Then add the water solution and the distilled water. And you want to put some drop of dye in it. The dye just gives some color and it's not regular water. It's okay if you don't put a dye in it. In those dampers, you're going to fill it up with the liquid you just made. There are two of those, so we're going to plug it and put it aside. There are two holes, so you're going to plug this hole sort of like in the middle. I do color rotations, so my white is on the far right of this assembly. If you don't know what color rotation is, I have another video. I'm going to put a link above. You definitely need to do the color rotation. It will make your printhead last 3-4 times longer. For this video, just remember my white is on far right. We're going to take two color dampers out, and we're going to take the white dampers out. We're going to put the color damper in the white damper slot. For the white damper, we take it out. We're going to put in a Ziploc bag. Oh, I forgot to say, we're shutting down a printer. I usually group my prints in a couple batches. So each batch I print at least 20 to 40 designs. So it's worthwhile for me to start a printer and shut down the printer properly. I've seen people like only do 5 shirts a print, and then they have to start, and then they have to shut down. You're going to have less motivation of do things if you print it out a little. For the first time using it, we need to remove some plastic tabs on the printhead carriage. And if you look down, you're going to see those columns. And just push down with your finger and push aside, and you're going to break those. Otherwise, you're going to find your damper cannot go in. So I got mine removed in the previous maintenance. Now we're going to put a 2 maintenance damper on the color spot. So basically, we'll put a color on the white spot and put a maintenance on the color spot. Oh, if you haven't done this before, stack a piece of a paper towel in this slot. Stack it really tightly, and that will save your life in the future. You may wonder why I do not put a maintenance solution on the white spot, or why I don't use any cleaning solutions. This is from my observation of the printhead. Let's take a look of the printhead under a microscope. After looking thousands of printheads, I'm thinking actually start a printhead repair business. Okay, here you can see in the middle is what we usually use for the white. The nozzle is round on the metal plates. It's actually pretty easy to clear the clogs on the nozzles because it's just a piece of metal. You can have lots of solutions, clean it, and make the nozzle open. What is clogging is the piezo chambers on the printhead. I have a repair shop. After compare what people usually use for the color ink and what they usually use for the white ink, I made some observations. Okay, let's take a closer look of the piezo chambers. What you call this shape? Parallelogram? Anyway, so you can see this one is not clogged. So your printer is going to send electric current and activate the piezo chip on film, and this little thing push against the nozzle and squirt out the ink. Your white going to accumulate around the sides of the chamber and clog it. Here we compare the old clear ones earlier. You can see this nozzle or this chamber is start clogging. You won't feel it, it still perform. However, eventually it's gonna accumulate and totally block it. And let me see if I can get one that's totally blocked. And this one is normally what you call the clog nozzles. Cleaning solution is two-edged swords. If you get a hardened, dried white ink, it can soften the material. However, you get a fresh white ink, it can cause a coagulate. Although the coagulate mass could be squirted out, however, it's very hard, so you created a clog. And this is you wash with water or wetter solution, and you can see the thing is okayish, and but the white is still white. There's some white accumulates, but most of them are okay. And those one on the surface will be cleaned out the next day when you switch back to white or switch back to color. And you can see a coagulation there, and a little bit more. However, if you use cleaning solution, it looks like a little bit more hardened. And I guess either you clear it out or you don't clear it out. So I'm not suggesting to use the cleaning solution to do the daily maintenance. It's your call. I use cleaning solutions when I see those really hardened ones cannot be cleared out by anything. So here's where I apply the cleaning solution. And of course, this is another topic and gonna take a long time to explain how to do it. So is there anything better than water or better than the wetter solution? Yeah, it's called color ink. It doesn't matter if you use a CMYK, and I'll just choose the two next one. And those more similar to the white ink than the wetter solution. So that's why I put the color ink on top of the white spot. Oh, by the way, I do the color swapping and maintenance damper installation with the printer power on. I do not shut down printer for this. It's your call. And if you put the paper towel where I showed you earlier, normally you won't get a spill. You can see my power is still on. As soon as I finish my last print, I wait the printer character set on this, get a solid red, and I start the shutdown. In your waste tank, you're gonna find two tubes. One is bigger, one smaller, and pick up the smaller tube. And use a syringe, draw 5 mil, and you're gonna feel the resistance. You feel the resistance because your printer is parked on the capping station naturally. And that means actually capping station is healthy. If you draw totally vacuum, and the thing like rubber just bounce back, or you draw air and there's no resistance, that means something wrong with your capping station. This will remove most of the white inks from the printhead. Now hold and press the ink button until you hear a click and the printer start cleaning itself. During the cleaning, you can also hold down the printhead maintenance button to draw out excessive inks. Okay, when the printer finished cleaning itself, and now we have the red and the cyan on this slot on the white, but the printer still think those two spots are white. So we're gonna print a picture that's totally white. And what this do is get the color ink flowing, and what I find is when the piezo is working, it helps to clean out the white accumulations are on the walls of the piezo chamber. So your flushing is remove the core of the white ink, and the printing with white, quote unquote white, is removing the remnants of the white. You can see I get a little piece of white coming out sometimes, and that's the one you want to remove. I usually print one square first, then I wait 5 to 10 minutes, print another one. But if I'm pressing on time, I just print one. We finish servicing the printer itself. Now, next thing is there are inks accumulated underneath the printer carriage. So we're going to do a shoe shine. This is the first time actually we shut down the printer. We shut down and restart the printer, and then we stick a piece of paper towel underneath. We just go do like a shoe shine. That will remove the extra ink on the bottom. Now we turn on the power in the back. For this model, when you turn on the power, the printer doesn't turn on. So do not turn on the printer yet. We add a little bit of water on the bottom so the printer will not dry during the next procedure. We're going to empty out the waste tank and the capping station tank underneath. Yeah, you probably don't know there's a tank there. It's like a drawer, you drag it out. Yeah, this one is pretty good. So I will just put it back. Now we slowly add water to the capping station and hold down the printer and maintenance button of this model. If your printer doesn't have a maintenance button, that's not this model, you can just get a big syringe stuck into the waste tube and slowly draw from there. And you're going to see the color come out first, then you're going to see white. And when you see white, and flip that flipper out from the bottom and clean it, and then put it back. Keep the process until you see all the white is gone. You only get a clear water. You can see still there's some white. Yeah, it's almost clear, still white. It'll take a couple minutes. I forgot to mention, you also need to use your finger to clean this rubber ring. If it's not cleaned, your capping station will not have a good seal against the printhead. When it's not sealed, the printhead is parked here, and when you draw from the waste tube, you're going to feel you are drawing air. That's the reason. Darn it, still white. Let's speed it up. All right, and for your printer, and we still need to clean that the smaller tube. So we add water until you have a ball on the top, and then, oh yeah, I changed the smaller tube to a bigger one, okay? But for yours, it's the smaller waste tube. You got two waste tubes. So I put a red there so I know this was the original smaller tube. So you suck from there, and here, the tube looks clean. Now it's important. Now we squirt water on the capping station until it cannot take anymore. Okay, and then we move the printhead on top of it, remove the paper towel, and we start a printer. We have to watch it until the red is solid again and the printhead is sitting on the printer naturally. Just leave the printer on and we completed the shutdown procedure. Now you can go anywhere you want to go and see things you want to see. Make sure the printer is on. I always just keep it on even when I go really far places. I know lots of you stop traveling or stop vacation after about a DTF. I myself, I probably ruined at least 20 printheads and look at hundreds of printheads and finally figure out how to maintain it. Now it's like a no-brainer. Mission accomplished. Now let me show you how to get it up. First, we move two color dampers to its own place. For the white, if it's within a day or 2 days, I won't do anything special. However, this time it's 5 days, so it's on the borderline. So I use the syringe to draw a little bit of ink out of each white damper, and then I install the white damper. Now again, from the small tube, I'm going to draw some ink. I usually go to 6 and slowly release, and do another 6 or 5 or 6, depending on how much I feel It really doesn't matter too much. And I do it three times. InkSonic has this printer management button on the left. So I'm going to press and hold this button and press and hold the ink button at the same time. I press and hold until the printer starts to clean itself. After the cleaning, your printer is ready. You can see we spent 15 minutes talking about how to shut it down, and we spent like a minute talking about how to get it up. That actually is about the portion of time you spend on the maintenance. If you maintain it correctly, you won't have problem printing at all. Okay, I hope you enjoyed this video. Visit us at bchtechnologies.com or locally at Greensboro, North Carolina. Cheers!